Deion Jordan. We're going to have Caron Butler right now. I love this story. Joined by a former right tackle from Florida State. He played 1 year, just 1 year at Florida State before entering the draft. He allowed only one sack this year. I'm joined by Menelik Watson. Menelik, nice to have you on. How are you?
I'm doing good, Jim. How are you doing?
Man, I'm great. I'm great. I love the story. You got to help me tell the story. It's pretty remarkable in the sense that if you go back to when you were growing up in Manchester, England, tell me, when you were a kid, what types of sports did you play?
When I was a kid, I just played soccer, really, until I messed my ankle up. I really enjoyed it. I loved it. It was my first love. Well, semi. She wasn't good to me, obviously, because she messed my ankle up. But I found basketball about a year after my accident, and found basketball, man. I really fell in love with that. You know what I mean? It really helped me, you know, not even get out of the country, just even travel England. You know what I mean? Because where I'm from, you know what I mean? You know, family didn't have much money. So, you know, if it weren't for sports, I mean, I don't think I would have ever left my city.
Man, talk about where you're from. You're from a tough, tough neighborhood in Manchester. What was life like growing up there?
Dangerous, man. It got really bad. I was just telling people how, when I was a kid, you know, we never had to lock the doors. But, you know, as I started getting older, you know, you start locking the doors, you know, people start moving out, you know what I mean? A couple of times, I'd be walking the street, coming from the store, and wondering if someone I know from my state or my area would pull up and say, listen, make sure you get home. You know, I've seen, you know, you've seen some people roaming the estate. You want to go home ASAP, you know what I mean? So, you know, to me, it was kind of just like, you know, I was born and raised in it, so it really didn't faze me. But, you know, looking back on it, you know, some of the things were really, you know, you don't really want anyone to experience.
Menelik Watson joining us. All right, then, so how much did you know about American football at that point?
I knew nothing about American football. I knew it rivaled rugby in terms of similarity, and I didn't like anything challenging rugby or anything English at the time.
Yeah, it's funny then, because then when people used to bring it up to you and they'd say things like, if you go to America, they're going to pressure you to play football. When you heard that, what was your response?
I was like, no way. I was like, I'm a basketball player. You know what I mean? I purposely wouldn't lift weights because I was always big, so I didn't want to get too big. You know what I mean? So, you know, that was my thing. I always wanted to be a basketball player. I was like, there's no way I'm playing American football. You know what I mean? And it was just kind of ignorance because I didn't know anything about it, but I didn't like it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, Menelik Watson, my guess. Exactly. All right, so you're a basketball player. So you take up basketball, and you end up getting a scholarship to play basketball in Marist. Marist is in New York. Yep. Manchester and Poughkeepsie are very different places. What was the culture change like when you got there?
It was a nice feeling getting off the plane in America and seeing things different. You know what I mean? Just being able to travel and get out of the country was a blessing, you know what I mean? So I just took it all with a grain of salt and just tried to really, you know, get to know, you know, the American culture and the way people did things in this country.
Yeah, see, the thing is, you knew you could play if you had the right coaching, but where did that confidence come from? How did you know you could play at that level?
You know what? I don't know. I've always had it. I was always that guy who said, you know, I'm going to play in the NBA one day. You know what I mean? I just felt like I just needed to be in the right situation. You know what I mean? The right coaching staff, the right conference, you know what I mean? I mean, the conference I played in at Marist, it was a big-time guard conference, and, you know, my size, I stood out big time. So, you know, I'd get a lot of charge calls, and I'd barely touch a guy, you know. But then when we played against the Big East teams, where it was physical, and, you know, they allowed a lot of physical play to happen, you know, I relished. So, you know, I just always felt like I just needed the right situation. I could shine. And, you know, I just didn't get that with Marist. You know, it just wasn't the right opportunity. And I just sensed that early on.
The Menelik Watson is my guest. All right, so, but you knew you could do it, and you were playing really well. But you made it pretty clear. Football was not on your radar. You wanted nothing to do with it. So how did all of a sudden did it become interesting to you, and how did you end up starting to play football?
Well, you know, at Marist, you know, I slipped into a really dark place, it's a place I'd never been before. It was kind of new territory, you know. I started getting into some things I never, you know, would have dreamed of being associated with. And, you know, I kind of came to this revelation one day that, you know, I need to change my life. And I just felt like, you know, I always feel like when you're unhappy, you know, you got to make changes. And I felt the change also involved me changing sport, you know. So, you know, at first it wasn't changing sport. At first my thought was going home back to the UK and just getting a job, you know, and just being a father to my little girl. But then,